Hey, this is Eric Hunter, and in this video, I want to talk about pendulum spin direction. And first, we're going to talk about it for pendulum alchemy and pendulum healing, and then I'll briefly touch upon it about dowsing or pendulum questions and answers. So here is an Asclepius pendulum. This is a really awesome pendulum for both pendulum healing, pendulum alchemy, and dowsing. And right now, the pendulum is moving in a clockwise direction. It's spinning in circles, the same direction as an old-fashioned clock would move. All right, basically, it's moving to the right. All right, the other direction it could go is counterclockwise or anti-clockwise. This is it's spinning towards the left side. And historically, in pendulum alchemy and pendulum healing, the direction that the pendulum moves was supposed to have a meaning. So, in my earlier books, I talked about this, and you'll commonly see this on the internet. Clockwise is meant that the pendulum is adding in energy into the system, and anti-clockwise means that the pendulum is supposed to be removing energy from the system. Because with pendulum alchemy and pendulum healing, the pendulum is an energy healing tool, and you use it to energize things that you want to have happen and make them more likely to occur. So, in the past, this was considered to be an important property of the pendulum, how it moved. And all the time, I get questions from people about, what direction should my pendulum be moving? Or I was trying to add energy into a system and my pendulum was moving anti-clockwise. Or people say, I was trying to take away energy and it was going clockwise. Like, what is going on here? Am I doing something wrong? Or am I supposed to move a pendulum one way or the other? So, after many years of experience with this, and I use the pendulum every day, all the time. I'm doing it for almost a decade now professionally. So, does it make a difference? The answer is it makes absolutely no difference at all what direction your pendulum spins. All that matters is this: is the pendulum moving in a circular or elliptic motion, or is it not? So the pendulum could be stopped, it could be going side to side, it could be going forward or backwards. That is the only thing you need to distinguish when doing pendulum alchemy or pendulum healing. If the pendulum is spinning in a circular motion or in an elliptical motion, this means that the pendulum is doing work. So, if you use a pendulum like this Asclepius and hold it over someone and you just let it spin, this means it's energizing their chakras, it's working on their aura, it's balancing out any energy imbalances that the person has, and it's doing it automatically without the use of any pendulum commands. Now, if you take the pendulum and say a command like, raise my consciousness to the highest level possible. So the pendulum spins around and you are the one spinning the pendulum. It doesn't matter if it seemingly spins by itself or if you intentionally just go like this. Either way, the pendulum is spinning and then after a while it will stop. And when it's spinning, it's energizing your statement or your command. And when it stops spinning, either it just stops like this or it goes forward or backwards or goes side to side. That means the command has been energized and you can either move on to the next command or stop. So the only thing that matters is this: is the pendulum spinning in a circular or elliptical motion, or is it not? That is the only thing that matters. It doesn't matter if it's going clockwise or anti-clockwise. I've found through experience it's totally irrelevant. Now, in the past, I tried to give some explanation of why it wouldn't matter. And this is a simple analogy. So think about your computer keyboard. It's covered in dust and you have to clean it. All right, well, there are two things you could do. Either you can get compressed air and blow the dust off, or you could use a vacuum cleaner and suck the dust off. So blowing the dust off would be the equivalent of going clockwise. You're adding in something. In that case, you're adding in air from the dust from the canister of air. You're shooting air onto your keyboard. So that's like adding energy with your pendulum. That's clockwise. Using a vacuum to suck the dust off to take it away would be anti-clockwise. But it really, you don't have to track this at all. It doesn't matter. Like, don't even pay attention to it. I wouldn't even spend time thinking about it. The main thing you want to just notice is my pendulum moving in a circle or is it not moving in a circle? If it's not moving in a circle, it is done. If it's moving in a circle, it's doing something. If you have a healing pendulum or a pendulum with really good energy, you hold it over a person's body, like if they have an injury on their body or there's some imbalance, you hold it over like a chakra, it will start to spin and it might go clockwise or it might go counterclockwise or anti-clockwise. Don't worry about it. It just means it's doing work. When you say a command, it might go clockwise or it might go anti-clockwise, but in either case, it doesn't matter. It's just doing work. So if you have your pendulum, you can just, and it's not moving, seemingly by itself. Now, you are the one always moving the pendulum. There's no way a pendulum can move without your hand moving it. So whether you're aware of it or not, you're moving it. Well, let's just say it's seemingly not moving on its own. You can spin it whatever way you intuitively feel is correct. Like you could say your pendulum command, like I'm going to send love and healing to everyone watching this video, and you can just make it go clockwise. Just give it a little push, let it spin until it stops. Or you could say, all right, I'm just going to do it anticlockwise. Send love to everyone watching this video. It doesn't matter. Both will work. So that's what I found out through years of experience. Even though I made a distinction about this in my earlier book, it really doesn't matter. And when people are talking about it on the web, it doesn't really matter. All it matters is it's spinning or not spinning. All right, now with dowsing, with using your pendulum for answering questions. I call dowsing pendulum Q&A. Dowsing is actually an inaccurate term, ironically. People often say when you use your pendulum for asking questions, that's dowsing. But technically, dowsing means looking for water with your pendulum. And so it's weird. But anyway, that's a side issue for another video. All right. But when you're using your pendulum to answer questions, there's this big deal made out of programming your pendulum. Like if it spins one way, it's a yes. If it spins another way, it's a no. And what I've found is that this is highly unreliable. That what will happen is you'll program your pendulum, and then all of a sudden, one day it will just start spinning the opposite direction. And then after a while, it becomes chaotic and it will be spinning in all kinds of directions, and you'll never really know what a yes or no is. So I really don't recommend programming your pendulum. I don't recommend doing yes or no in the air. With circular or with any kind of motions, like either forward or backward, yes or no, I found this to be highly unreliable. What I recommend you do instead is make a chart. It could be something as simple as a yes/no chart, where you write a, I'll just grab a piece of paper here. So, you just take a little sheet of paper, like this piece of paper right here. You just put a Y on one side and a no on the other. Y, no. And then you just swing your pendulum towards that. And if it swings towards the yes, it's a yes. If it swings towards the other side, it's a no. You could also, I have charts based on energy, and it's way more reliable to use one of those charts. So, if you're doing yes and no in the air, I would strongly recommend you stop doing that. I've found it to be highly unreliable. The other thing is that let's say you've been doing yes or no in the air for like decades, and all of a sudden you start learning about pendulum healing and pendulum alchemy. And the pendulum is spinning around and it's going in a direction that would be your no or your yes. Like, does that matter? It doesn't matter at all. So, pendulum alchemy and pendulum healing is a completely separate discipline from so-called pendulum dowsing. They're not related at all. So, it doesn't matter what you have for yes or no. With pendulum alchemy and pendulum healing, circular motion energizes things. And then when it's not moving in a circle, it's not being energized. When you're dowsing, you might be accidentally energizing something when the pendulum is spinning for in a circle for a yes, but it's completely incidental to the process. So if you trained your pendulum to move a certain way for dowsing, it will have absolutely no effect on your ability to do pendulum healing. So, like I said in the beginning, the main thing to know is that for pendulum alchemy and pendulum healing, moving in a circle means it's doing something. When it's not moving in a circle, it means it's not doing something. And you either move on to the next operation or you stop. All right, post your questions and comments below. I hope that was helpful, and I'll see you in another video. Bye.